Hello and welcome to the channel. My name is Drew and this is Just a Guy Linux. And this is my video about moving from GitHub to Codeberg. So if you spent any time on my channel at all, you'd know that most of the content that I put out there is based on some script that I've written, whether it be DWM or Sway or BSPWM or Butter Bash or something like that. And until very recently, those had been hosted on GitHub. So now the bulk of my projects that were at github.com/DrewGriff now reside at codeberg.org/JustAGuyLinux. Now this wasn't just a simple migration. This was me being a little bit more philosophical at wanting to be a FOSS advocate. So here's the thing. I chose Linux over Windows and macOS because it was better. I mean, flat out, it was better. It has a better community, it has better transparency, and it has user freedom. Ding, inside joke. So why am I hosting all of my FOSS projects on a proprietary Microsoft platform? And I couldn't come up with a reason. I didn't have to, so I decided not to anymore. I mean, I remember an interview with Steve Ballmer, when he was the CEO of Microsoft, and he flat out called open source and Linux a cancer in 2001. And then Microsoft buys GitHub for $7.5 billion in 2018. Now, either they had some kind of spiritual awakening about the power of community and open collaboration, or they figure out how to make some money off of this. So here's the thing that I just had to recognize. Every line of code that I put on GitHub, that includes every script, every configuration file, every solution that I shared in the community, anything that I contributed to a different FOSS project, all of that is now training data for Copilot, for the Microsoft AI. And that is all generating revenue for Microsoft. I mean, after all, that is just smart business, right? I mean, but the thing that also bothers me is that you have zero say, or I have zero say in any of this. If GitHub changes something, you just deal with it. If they, let's say, if they modify their terms of service, you accept it. If they remove a feature, oh well, you know, it's tough luck. You know, they'll even charge you if you exceed a certain amount of disk space on a specific project, which is crazy to me because what you are is not their customer. I mean, in that way, you are their customer because you will be paying, but they are using you as inventory more than anything else. So at risk of sounding a little preachy, I apologize if it has come off that way. The fact of the matter is this is just my story and I am telling it in a way that might seem a little preachy. However, I am very impressed and excited that I am using a different platform, and I just wanted to kind of like represent that. So let me show you what the differences are, at least for me as a casual user. So in the last section, I mentioned talking about the differences between GitHub and Codeberg. There's just not that many. So I will be talking about more the similarities with a few exceptions, okay? So what you're currently looking at right now is my old GitHub account at github.com/DrewGriff. As you can tell, it's showing basically that I moved everything over. There is a few, actually two pinned repos there, but if I go to the repositories, you're going to see that most of them have either become archived or have been basically said this repo has been moved. So there's two different ones, like the ghosty one, for example, has been archived, is now read-only. And then this one that's an active project, Butterscripts, basically says it has been moved. The one exception here at the top, at least, is this Genie themes. And the reason why is because I have contributed three or four themes. I think it's three so far, but I have a fourth in the works. And it just makes sense to do these, to have this Git pull request on the same platform.
So while we're still on GitHub, let's go to the Butterscripts repo since it's sitting right there. It's going to show that it is a public archive. It was archived on this date. It also shows in the about that this has moved, and it shows where it moved to. And now the repo, you know, the README has been updated to reflect that as well. And it's hosted on Codeberg. Okay. Now, the obvious things are that you're going to see that people use with Git all the time are issues and pull requests and actions and so on. You have all of this. Let's go to Codeberg now. And this is the home page. And you're going to see the repos list. Again, very similar. And if we go to the Butterscripts, which is actually at the top, how nice. Okay, you're going to see issues and pull requests and activities and so on. As far as the README is concerned, it's going to be structured exactly the same. You have complete control over it. And you're going to be, actually, I like this project as an example because you get to see some of this stuff in this section under the slash browsers. There's more installation and documentation. Oop, I guess I have to, there you go. And it talks about, you know, what the scripts actually do and so on and so forth. Let's go back. So same thing with Discord, FastFetch, MKV, Merge, NeoVim, and so on. So what is the point? I guess the point is it's near the same. There is familiarity across both platforms, the issues, the pull requests, the code, the commands to, you know, to git push, to git clone, to git pull. All of it is the same. So I guess, I mean, what is the differences? I guess it's who's running it, right? That's, I guess, the difference that I should talk about. So what is Codeberg? Well, Codeberg is a democratic, community-driven, nonprofit software development platform. You can read all of this. Codeberg is a registered nonprofit in Germany. It's not a subsidiary hiding behind some nonprofit claims, nor is it funded by venture capital with profit expectations in the future. Members, let's go bylaws. Members elect the board, users vote on platform direction, community decisions are taken over corporate profits because there are no corporate profits to prioritize. And it sounds familiar, doesn't it? To me, it does at least. And that's why I kind of thought this is basically the Debian model, but for code hosting instead of operating systems. Think about it. Debian developers elect their project leaders. Debian votes on general resolutions. The community decides on directions. There are no shareholders. There's no board optimizing for quarterly earnings. And we trust Debian because of that structure. And it's why it's been rock solid for 30 plus years. I just wanted to also mention, just because I became a member doesn't mean that you have to become a member. It is free. So you can create a free account and use any of the free and open source software that is out there. Now, let me talk about Codeberg pages a minute. This is actually a big discussion within the membership. Fairly recently, it is now closed because the decision was to provide some type of disclaimer about Codeberg pages. It is currently provided with a best effort approach, and the software is currently in maintenance mode. Does it work? Yes. Is it robust like GitHub pages? Absolutely not. It is probably the feature that is lagging the most in terms of its comparison to GitHub. Now, as it says, it does host static websites. For example, my son has his personal website that I helped him build at Codeberg Pages. It is truly a static website, and it is using a custom domain name. So all of that works. Now, if you are someone is using, I don't know, something like Hugo, for example, this might not be appropriate for you. Unfortunately, it is lagging behind. That's just a fact. In fact, I think it's clear to everybody within the membership that this is probably
the worst part of Codeberg, and that is Codeberg pages. Does it work? Yes, but not to be able to compete with something like GitHub pages. Let's go back over to my Codeberg page. And I just wanted to show this real quick. If you go to justaguylinux.com, basically what it is now is a URL redirect to my Codeberg Justaguy wiki. And so instead of having any type of hosting or the need to use something like mkdocs, I decided I was just going to use the Codeberg wiki. And it works great. Is it any different than a GitHub wiki? Nope, not at all. In fact, I guess that's exactly my point, is there's more similarities than there are differences. I guess the only thing that's different is who's running it. And I guess that's the end of this demonstration about my Codeberg page. Look, I'm not here to tell you to delete your GitHub account, okay? I get it. It is convenient. Everyone's there, and I get it. It works. But here's what I realized. I spent years complaining about proprietary platforms like Windows while I was using a proprietary platform to host my own open source work. And at some point, that just felt ridiculous to me. So is Codeberg perfect? No. In fact, I would argue that some of the issues that I've had in terms of it, GitHub is just robust. I think that's the only way to kind of like categorize it. And there's GitHub effects, and there is a lot more to the software. So it's not an equal playing field there. Would I do it again? In a heartbeat, I would do it again because I don't know. Do I feel better about myself? Maybe a little. I don't know if that's petty or not. But I don't really care either. So I did make the move. I am now a voting member. I actually have some say in how Codeberg is run or is developed. When I share my work, it is hosted on a community infrastructure and that runs on FOSS software. So if you've gotten to this point and have not turned away, thanks for watching this video. Generally, I don't do videos like this. As most of you know, I generally sit behind a computer screen and that's all you see is just the computer screen. I'm usually not a talking head in any way, shape, or form unless I'm on the podcast. Shout out the LinuxCast podcast, broadcasting on Tuesday nights. So I will leave a link in the description below for just about everything. And thanks again. See ya.